So today I am filming a at-home leg workout. It is mostly quad and glute focused. I did a lot of the movements in regular time for like 3 to 5 reps, and then I sped it up just to move the video along quicker. But that way you can see kind of how slow or fast I'm doing a movement, and then I will also do a voiceover of what I'm doing and what it's targeting. Get down. I did 3 rounds of the circuit, and then I added some extra glute stuff at the end, which you'll see. So you can take as many breaks as you need to if you're trying to follow along with this workout, or you can not take any breaks. I took a few little breaks. I probably would say like I waited a minute between each circuit, and then I started it again, and I did all the exercises all the way through, and then would rest at the end. Also, you can do as many reps as you want and sets. So I did 3 sets, and I did about anywhere from 10 to 20 reps on each exercise that I was doing. And you can do more or less. You can also do all of these with body weight or with weights. I used 10-pound weights today. It took me probably 12 to 15 minutes. Not even. It took me 10 to 12 minutes to do this workout, so there's really no excuse not to get it done. Everybody has 10 minutes a day that they can devote to working out at home, so this is lower body. I will be doing upper body and then also a full body as well pretty soon. So you can do home workout and gym workouts with the same movements. It's just going to be a difference in weight in terms of what I do at the gym, because I do a little bit of cardio, but mostly the movements are the same. So for example, if you're trying to work out your quads, a good exercise for that would be any form of a squat if your knees can handle it with or without weight. So here today I just did regular squats with weights on my kind of shoulders, 10 pounds each, so 20 pounds total, and then I did some jump squats. So at the gym, I could do the same thing. My weight would just be a lot more. Like the other day I did some squats just to kind of see where my max is, and I could do 165 for like 3 reps. So obviously that's a way more weight, but it's the same movement. It's still a squat. Same thing with jump squats. You could do jump squats at home or at the gym. I don't ever do those with weight. You could do pause squats at home or at the gym. If you don't have a gym membership, don't feel like you can't get in shape or be active, because there's so many things you could do at home with just a few weights. I got those at Walmart or whatever probably a few years ago. Same with these resistance bands. I got a set of 3, a blue, red, and yellow one. I believe I also got those at Walmart. They were like 10 bucks, not even, for these resistance bands, which resistance bands are so awesome for upper body or lower body workouts. And they're so inexpensive and such a good tool to use if you don't have a gym. So that's basically it. I will be doing more workouts with at home and at the gym. So hopefully you guys will learn some stuff. Let me know if you have any questions or suggestions for what you would like me to focus on in a video. So thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys soon. Bye. So I'm just starting with some basic squats here. I'm a little bit wider than shoulder width apart, but not completely into a sumo squat, because I do want to keep the focus mainly on my quads and not on my glutes for this movement. So I'm just trying to do them slow and controlled, and I'm doing 20 squats here, and then I speed it up just to move past into the next movement. But if you'll notice, I am doing them nicely slow and controlled, so I want a lot of tension on those quads as I'm going up and down, and then I will squeeze the glutes at the top when I am finished. Next, I am doing just some jump squats here, 10 I think, just quickly jump squats to get some kind of cardio involved with some more stress on those quads to really burn them out. Next, we're using my resistance band with some dance moves, and I'm just doing side steps to target my outer glute area, and I did 10 to each side. You could do as many or as few as you want on these. The more you do, the more you'll feel that burn in that outer glute area. Next, I'm just going to do hip thrusters here, and I have a 10-pound weight across my hip bones.
you can do these nice and slow, and you want a good squeeze in the glutes at the top of the movement. You can hold that for as many seconds as you want. I just do probably a 1 second squeeze here. You can also do these single leg, so you can cross one leg over your knee and then do single leg hip thrusters. Those are just gonna be a little bit more difficult. This is more of a beginner move. And then I will repeat this sequence two more times. So I just have this sped up to go through it twice. So for a total of three sets of this circuit. So what you really want to focus on with these home workouts are time under tension of the muscle. So like with these side steps here, the furthest step you take out is going to be the most tension on that muscle. So if you really focus on that contraction, you're going to feel more afterwards. Same with these hip thrusts here. The more tension you have at the top of that movement and the squeeze in the glutes is really going to make that muscle grow. So you just want to focus on the time under tension and the squeeze in the muscle. With these squats, when you go down into that final squat, you can even hold that for a second or two and make it a pause squat, and that's really gonna help as well with the tension on that muscle and just to help get the best out of your workout. Also, feel free to add to this workout. You could do some lunges, you could do jump lunges. Lunges are gonna be a good full leg workout to do. I didn't do any in this just because I forgot to, but I would really suggest if you feel not burned out by the end of this workout, feel free to add whatever you want and get creative and let me know what you guys come up with. I am ready for the road less traveled, suiting up for my crowning. This test is my own cross to bear, but I will get there. It's never easy to be chosen. Lastly, I am going to add in some extra glute work because I felt like my glutes weren't targeted enough in this workout. So they just are just going to be banded kickbacks, and you'll notice that glute muscle is contracting at the top of the movement, and you can do as many of these as you want. I think I did 15 per side. For two or three sets. You could do, like I said, as many as you want. I've done up to like 30 to 40 banded kickbacks, and you really feel the burn there. Just depending on your level of exercise, where you're wanting to achieve. And then I just have it sped up here to go through it. And the band will roll up like that, no big deal. Just kind of straighten it back out and continue the movement. I like to loop it around my foot a little bit to keep the band as straight as possible. I was really struggling at the end here, but we got it done. So the last thing I'm going to be doing are Bulgarian split squats on a chair with 10 pounds in each hand. So my leg was sliding all over the place because of my sock on the chair, so these were really difficult. But basically, you're just going to go down into a squat and come back up, and then I just do some jump squats at the end to really burn that out. So there it is.